Brothers and I see you. Thank you. Oh, Thank you. I'm gonna go to the song which I wrote. It's called She Gives Me a Religion.
Thank you. knows what words are worth. Yes, she rolled on a solid ground. And look how
same old street. She gon' dance on
the ship from my neck down to my spine. I didn't mean to say that. Yes, they should.
I think it was you who did that.
Right.
I don't know if you did a traditional number.
Oh,
Thank you. You're listening to Lifestyle with me, Pete Geraghty. Well, last week I was lucky enough to get a ticket to the Van Morrison concert that was held in the tiny parish church of Stigumber, down in West Somerset. It seemed remarkable that a superstar of Van Morrison's stature would ever agree to such a performance. Well, the man who managed to put the whole thing together was Andy Locke, a special needs teacher working at Somerset College of Arts and Technology, and who lives in Stigumber. I managed to corner him after the concert, and I was able to discover how this Stigumber connection came about.
We got married in 83 in Stigumber, and we used some tracks from the Beautiful Vision album. My wife walked down the aisle to Conswater, which is an instrumental track, in the church, and purely to get a letter back from him to say, you can do it. I wrote to the record company saying, do you mind if we use the music? Had the reception back at our house, and about 11 o'clock the phone rang. My wife answered the phone and came back in after about 10 minutes and said, Van Morrison's coming here. And we all went, don't be stupid, there's no way Van Morrison would come here. And at 3:45 he turned up, walked in the door, stayed an hour, talked to us, and went away again. And nobody had ever played his music in a church. And he wanted to come to the wedding, but we got married at 9:30, which meant he couldn't get down there in time. And about a month later they came down again for coffee. I mean, I've had the idea for years that his music would sound really good in a church, and I've never done anything about it. And then the last tour that he played, I saw him at Bristol Hippodrome and just left a letter saying, I don't know if you remember coming to our wedding, because we'd not heard of a tour since 83. Why don't you come and play the village church? And he rang up about a fortnight later and said, yeah, great idea, I'll come. And Georgie Fame last night said he was asked and said yes straight away.
There's been quite a lot of secrecy about this, hasn't there? And odd sort of little bits in the media. How have you managed to deal with the whole organisation of it all?
The tickets were sold purely by word of mouth. I mean, I know enough people to ring up who liked Van Morrison, who could tell friends, and we obviously didn't want publicity, because if God knows how many cars invaded the village, it was that more than people.
What did the vicar think of all this? I mean, was he a Van Morrison fan? Did he knew who Van Morrison was?
No, he didn't. He'd never actually heard of him. I played him some tracks, and I mean, he liked the ideas, he liked the music. He went back to the parochial church council, who agreed to do it.
I mean, some vicars are a bit concerned about video cameras coming to do weddings and things like this. I mean, it's a pretty broad-minded attitude of his, wasn't it?
You've got Stigumber Music Festival. There's a Palm Court Orchestra in the church last summer, and he is sort of all for the idea that the church should provide things for the public in a village like that anyway, and bring music to the people. And the church seems to be the obvious place in a village anyway, because it's the biggest place. But, I mean, Van Morrison's music was just particularly relevant to being played in a church.
Van Morrison's come in for this sort of, he's sort of very reluctant and shy, and he's a bit of a strange sort of bloke. And I mean, you've met him now 3 or 4 different occasions. What sort of a chap is he?
Very, very shy.
Not the big superstar. I mean, he's sold an awful lot of albums. He's been, you know...
No, he's not at all into that. I mean, we went back to the hotel with him last night, and I mean, he's anything but the sort of reluctant, bad-tempered person that people say he is. I mean, it was really nice in the hotel. He actually said it was the best gig he's ever done because the audience was so good, because the audience was so quiet. He was actually able to play very quiet songs, which is something he'd given up. And, I mean, he thought it was great. But no, he's nothing like people say he is.
And also, on keyboards, we had Georgie Fame.
Yeah.
Who is actually a Somerset resident, isn't he, I think, now?
Yeah.
It strikes me that the Georgie Fame connection, the Bristol Hippodrome gig... The Avalon Sunset, one almost begins to think that Van Morrison is actually living somewhere in Somerset.
He doesn't, but somebody was saying last night that Somerset's his second home. I mean, apparently he really likes Somerset. And the Georgie Fame thing came about purely because Georgie Fame and the Blue Flames backed the last tour. And obviously he's got very close to Georgie Fame. And Georgie Fame was the first person he asked to do it.
What do you reckon it is about his music? I was listening last night at the concert. And, I mean, you don't really need to hear what he's saying half the time. He's got just an amazing mood in his voice, hasn't he?
Some people said they couldn't hear what he was saying, but I'd like to say I don't think it mattered. There was an article in NME a few months ago when he said something about his aim was to, through his music, was to get a feeling of peace and tranquility in the listener. And there was a point last night when he did Solid Ground, followed up by No Guru, No Method, No Teacher. And that was when he actually got it. There were actually, I looked around and there were people in the audience just sitting with their eyes closed. and it was just so peaceful, and the whole of the church around him made us think that was exactly what I'd intended when I thought about it. And it worked, and it worked perfectly.
It's worked, fine. What have you got planned next, or is that a secret as well?
Well, I said to him last night, I'm going to go for Bob Dylan next, and he said, you don't stand a chance. But I want to keep it going, because I think if you can establish a really nice place for people to come and play, I think other people will come and do it, and I'm sure they had a good time. Mm. I don't know, I mean, I want to do something else. He's offered to come back sometime in the near future, and he's talking about doing a tour of Somerset churches.
That would be absolutely remarkable, and you wouldn't be able to keep that a secret all the days.
Well, you would need to, then. I think it would depend on... I mean, if we get the same police cooperation that we got last night, which was absolutely brilliant, and there was no problem at all anywhere. Everybody parked really well, everybody found somewhere to park. I've not talked to any residents yet, but I don't think any residents will mind what happened last night.
I was talking there to Andy Locke, who organised that remarkable Van Morrison concert in Stigumber last week.
West Somerset correspondent Martin Hest. Martin, a real one-off.
Well, it certainly was a unique evening, Simon. Yeah. It's not every day that an international megastar gives a concert in a parish church in rural England, after all. Indeed, for Van Morrison, it was a first as well. He admitted to the 300-strong audience that he had often prayed in a church before, but never played in one. It all started with a bit of a press scrummage at the doors of the church, which got the journalists nowhere and which rankled with the musicians. The concert and its time and date was a sort of unofficial secret, known only to ticket holders who got in on the sellout by word of mouth. But a local free sheet reporter annoyed organisers by blowing the gaff this week. Van Morrison's manager, however, refused to play ball with the collected press, saying that the star would not get out of his car unless reporters went away. I was lucky enough to get a ticket some months ago, so I was the only press man to get into the concert, which I'm happy to report lived up to all of the fans' expectations. Georgie Fame started the ball rolling with a sultry electronic organ piece, but then standing applause filled the ancient building when Van Morrison himself strolled onto the stage from behind the pulpit, looking, I must say, for all the world, like a small-town livestock auctioneer with his portly little Irish figure and a well-balding head of hair. In his case, looks certainly belie the power of the man's voice. I mean, he really does have an incredible voice. His raunchy, unique style of singing filled the church for 2 hours before a standing ovation brought one of the world's top megastars back for a rather unexpected encore of Down by the Riverside. There's no doubt, Simon, that everyone present realised they just witnessed a one-off experience. Top international rock stars don't often perform in lonely parish churches. And Somerset's rector, Roger Spur, was in fact delighted by the evening.
I'm delighted about everybody coming and feeling that the church was a place in which they could be at home.
Was it a very difficult decision for you as a priest to go ahead with this concert?
No, it wasn't. I believe that the church should be what it always was in the past, a place where things happened, not just on one day of the week, but on any day of the week and every day of the week. Often churches were built without pews, so that things could happen in them. And, all right, we've had a happening, a super one.
So at the end of the night, did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy
the
music?
Yes. I had reservations beforehand, but... Yes, it grows on me, and the content was super, the audience were lovely, nobody abused the privilege of using a church, so I'm delighted.
And I suppose at the end of the night, you've raised some money for your beautiful painting here, which adorns the area around which the band was playing tonight.
That's right, we have. I think we've probably got almost enough to do it completely, but probably with the odd grants that will be available, we should be able to complete it.
Right. And we'll come back again when it's all
ready for rededication or whatever.
Well, perhaps we'll get Van Morrison back for that.
I'd like to think so.
Well, that's the rector. Well, that's Roger Spur talking about last night's pop concert there given by Van Morrison and Georgie Fay. Martin Hespar, reporter, was there.